Hello everyone, I will present you some tips what I learned during working on the website and how to effectively promote your KDE project on the web. Firstly, we have a web theme for the website, call it Helvetia. It provides all the KDE branding out of the box. This is the look of the web a website created with the Helvetia theme. And it's used by many websites. So I think I listed every website here, but maybe I forgot some. And the advantage of the system is what it's Bootstrap 4 based. So all the documentation about Bootstrap is provided by the theme. It's hosted on the KDE CDN. So every time I do an update, it's propagated to the every website almost instantly. And it provides all the KDE branding, so the Notosan font, the Mad KDE logo, the blue accent color, and many other things. But it's only a CSS theme, so you need to create all the HTML boilerplate yourself. And for this, there is a GCal theme. GCal is a static website generator used by many websites in KDE, and it's provide all the boilerplate for you, so it's even faster to create a website. And we have some documentation. Firstly, the tutorial created by Thiago Sueto, many thanks to him. And we have also in the README many configuration options detailed on it. And there is also an example folder you can copy and have your website almost instantly done. You don't need to fill the content. And you also have a Breeze icon font developed for the web. It's quite easy to use. You only need to include the CSS file from the CDN, and then you can just create icons by including them. And I have a list of all the icons and in this website, as CDN, KDE.org, please icons.html. Okay, so next tip to create a cool, good website is the content. And it's quite important. And for this, I would recommend to not create a wall of text like in this example, but instead, add some images, like in and colors, to make it pleasant for the eyes, and so what the user what come to your website is attracted by the by it. Another helpful advice is to describe This is to not describe the what the application is, but explain what the application allows the user to do. So instead of saying what Plasma is a desktop environment based on widgets, what is fast and efficient, and you need to say what it allows to do. Even it's a bit of lie because it's not Plasma what allow you to surf the web. It's a web browser, but it's you need to explain what you can do with the application. And okay, and last thing to say is not everyone need a website. It's a lot of work to maintain, and it's better to not have a website and have a website what is unmaintained and where we've screenshot with what are 10 years old. So for this use case, we have the KDE.org applications what lists all the websites and create a good-looking home page for your project. It's based on the upstream data. So every time you do an update to your upstream data, what are also displayed on Discover and GNOME Application Center. It's also deployed to the website, and it supports localization, screenshot, but also release information. So you can write blog posts in it, a sort of blog post with news about your application. You can add link to the stores, for example, the Microsoft Store, the Play Store, F2B, like what Jonathan said earlier. And it's quite less work to do than maintaining a website alone. Okay. I will have two buffs, one on Wednesday, the 9th September at 70 UTC. And this is for people who would like to improve their websites for your project or discuss how to improve it. And I have second buff, planned about the developer platform. It's another project that I'm developing. A preview is already available at develop.kde.org. And I would like to discuss the content of the website and the documentation for third-party developers. Okay, thanks everyone. All right, that's it.